Hey there, everybody! Chris from Orlando here, and today we're going to be talking about pop culture. Not pop century, as you might think. When it comes to movies, / TV shows, / even video games, creators just love hiding little nods and Easter eggs to some of their favorite properties, and Disney parks are certainly no different. I mean, Disneyland is just a 37-minute drive from Hollywood, and with Disney pretty much buying everything it can, why not appease your new mouse overlords with a cool Easter egg? Or at least take a pot shot in defiance of the inevitable. Today, we're going to be taking a look at Disney parks referenced in pop culture. Let's start with Disney references itself. We obviously have the range of movies based on attractions, ranging in quality from really good to bad to OH GOD MY EYES! But that's too easy. We need to go deeper. Let's start with Meet the Robinsons, the movie most people only remember from the line, "I will reread the real ones." But there's a shot when Lewis and Wilbur first get to the future of them flying past a place called Todayland, an obvious reference to Tomorrowland, because it's in the future, so it's Todayland, get it? Get it? Get it? But clearly visible is Space Mountain and, oddly, not Astro Orbiter, but the rocket jets. It was probably selected in order to match with the rest of the white buildings in the shot. Also on the soundtrack for the movie, there's a cover of There's a Great Big Beautiful Tomorrow by They Might Be Giants. I don't think it's part of their regular set list, but request it next time you go see them in concert. See what happens. But we're not done with Tomorrowland references yet. We're heading over to, well, Tomorrowland. There is, of course, the iconic white dome of Space Mountain in the background as Casey first explores Tomorrowland, but also the movie opens with Great Big Beautiful Tomorrow, and Frank actually first enters Tomorrowland through Small World of all places at the 1964 World's Fair. Weird flex, but okay. Speaking of Small World, man, people love to take the mick out of this ride. And rightfully so. There's references in it from everything from Ant-Man to Percy Jackson, The Simpsons, Rugrats in Paris, and Rick and Morty, with characters normally mocking how annoying the song is. And of course, there's Lion King, where even the villainous Scar is afraid of the song. Rightfully so. I mentioned Rick and Morty just then, but there's an entire episode inside an amusement park called Anatomy Park. And while the park logo, the CEO, and events of the episode, minus the giant flying homeless man, is mostly based on Jurassic Park, there are two more rides in the park that are references to Disney. First, we have Great Moments with Reuben, a reference to Disneyland's Great Moments with Mr. Lincoln, and of course Rick's favorite ride, Pirates of the Pancreas, is a nod to Pirates of the Caribbean. Speaking of Pirates of the Caribbean, man, I am the king of segues! Pirates of the Caribbean served as the inspiration for popular 90s point-and-click adventure games, the Monkey Island series. However, there is an out-and-out reference to the iconic ride in Monkey Island 2, LeChuck's Revenge, in which Guybrush Threepwood finds himself in a jail cell and needs to retrieve a key from the dog standing guard. And hey, that dog's name is Walt. Surely that's a reference too, right? You think so, but no. Turns out the game's artist's dog was called Walt, and that's what it's referring to. Sorry, artist dude, but no one's going to think of your good boy when they see that name. Staying in the realm of video games, let's talk about my favorite game series of all time, Kingdom Hearts. In Kingdom Hearts 3, as you're battling Heartless and the complicated plot, you'll have the ability to summon ride vehicles to aid you. This includes Mad Teacups, Blaster Blaze, a reference to Buzz Lightyear Astro Blasters, Magic Carousel, King Arthur's Carousel, and Mountain Coaster, Big Thunder Mountain Railroad. There are a couple more, but they appear to me more generic ride vehicles rather than based on an actual attraction. Speaking of Big Thunder Mountain, I'm unstoppable! Here's one that might not be intentional, but it's still fun in retrospect. Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom. While Indy is being chased by bad guys in a minecart, A lot of the sound effects you hear as the carts zoom down the track are actually sounds from Big Thunder Mountain. And keep in mind, this was years before Indiana Jones would get his own ride in the parks, and Lucasfilm was bought by Disney. So it may not be an on-purpose reference, but I'm counting it anyway, it's my video. And the last thing we're going to talk about today, because there's so many others, I just can't get them all in one video. So make sure you subscribe to the channel so you can see part 2 next week, is one of my favorite movies, The Rocky Horror Picture Show. Rocky isn't just a movie, it's an experience. If you've only seen the movie, you've only seen half of it. See, Rocky is best viewed in a theater because there's actors performing the movie in front of the movie, a whole mess of things like rice and playing cards being thrown around, and jokes being yelled out at the movie. Essentially, audience members will change lyrics to the songs and do a call and response with the movie in order to make jokes. Seriously, if you've never seen the Rocky Horror Picture Show live, once Coruscant Virus is gone, go see it. I recommend The Rich Weirdos, hashtag not sponsored. Anyway, there are 3 references to the parks. Although, 2 might just be local to the Orlando area, but I'm still counting anyway, it's my video. First, the character of Columbia is seen wearing Mickey ears. Aw, aren't they adorable? The other 2 are references that the audience makes. The first one for sure only works in Orlando, because when Janet asks, "Well, where will you go? We're in the middle of nowhere," there's a pause as Brad thinks where someone in the audience asks, "Where do all the freaks, f**ks, and furries go for work here in Orlando?" To which Brad replies, "Didn't we pass a castle a few miles down the road?" The other reference comes a few minutes later during the song Over at the Frankenstein Place, when Brad and Janet sing "There's a light." The audience replies, "Over at the Epcot Center!" Because the glass dome looks like Spaceship Earth. A detail that took me way too long to notice. So that's the end of part 1. Make sure you tune in next week for part 2, but in the meantime, what are some Disney park references in pop culture that you've seen? Leave them in the comments down below. And don't forget to like and share this video and give the channel a subscribe. You can also follow me on Facebook and Instagram, links in the description down below. I'm Chris from Orlando, and I can't think of a pop culture joke to sign off on. Oh well, I'll be back. Take care, y'all. One love. Don't hurt nobody.